Chapter 12, Membrane Proteins. Cells and organelles within them are bounded by membranes. Membranes is basically has a bilayer of lipid where the hydrophilic portions on each two outer surfaces and hydrophobic in between. The proteins are embedded in this layer. Membrane proteins could be classified into two large classes, peripheral protein and integral protein. Peripheral protein is attached to membrane, but it could be detached without significant structural denaturation. Integral protein, in contrast, bound to membrane very tightly, so that the isolation of such integral protein usually end up with structural destruction. It could be either transmembrane or partially embedded proteins. The function of proteins in membrane may play a very important role, such as transport, metabolism, like transferring light energy into chemical or electric type, and sometimes they are involved in cell-to-cell recognition, and also signal transduction, as you see with the hormone, chemotaxis, and light, something like that. Integral membrane proteins could be classified into four different types. Transmembrane domain composed of alpha helix in A, just a single transpiring alpha helix, multiple number of alpha helices in B, and then in D you can see a protein that is anchored to the membrane by one alpha helix parallel to the plane of the membrane, sometimes linked to the ferric sheet. In C, you can see instead of alpha helix, several beta strand forms transmembrane domain. In A, you can see the schematic drawing of membrane protein with hydrophobic and philic regions. This membrane protein could be isolated in separate forms by adding a detergent. The hydrophobic part of the detergent molecules binds to the protein's hydrophobic surfaces, while the detergent polar head group face the solution. In this way, the protein detergent complex acquires an essentially hydrophilic surface with the hydrophobic part buried inside the complex. This kind of solubilized protein detergent complexes are the starting material for purification and crystallization. In B, you can see a membrane protein crystallized with the detergent bound to each hydrophobic protein surface. Basically, membrane proteins are very difficult to crystallize. So different strategies have been developed in this field. In this textbook, there are two methods are introduced. First, using antibody, so that the membrane protein antibody complex just increase hydrophilic surfaces that just allow a better chance to make crystal. Second one is using lipid phase. So making just a long chain lipid with the addition of a small amount of water, that could make a continuous lipid phase. This function is a crystallization media. So proteins in this media, they just diffuse laterally and attach to the any nucleation site, producing bigger crystals. Given the difficulty of obtaining good membrane protein crystals, electron microscope is widely used to obtain some idea about three-dimensional structures of membrane proteins. Bacteriorhodopsin from Halobacterium halobium, it could convert light into the proton gradient across the bacterial cell membrane. It has the retinal pigment, which function as light absorption. In 1975, the first glimpse of how it looks like was obtained by EM technique. The initial resolution was 7 angstrom, built in A, later improved to the much better resolution, clearly showing 7 alpha helices tilt by 20 degrees across the membrane. Later, you can see the 3 angstrom resolution clearly shows such properties. In addition, with bound retina in the middle. All these structures were determined by EM technique, but later the X-ray crystallography technique confirmed this kind of features. Bacteriorhodopsin is a light-driven proton pump. How it works? Light absorption of retinal pigment causes retinal geometry from trans to cis double bond in green region, changing the end region with dark blue and red regions, rotate by half turn, as you see in the bottom. As a consequence, protons are pumped from the cytosol to the extracellular space. That is proton gradient. Retinal is bound in a pocket of bacteriorhodopsin about same distance from both sides at the middle. The pigment forms a shift base with a lysin residue 216. It is covalently linked to the nitrogen atom of the lysin side chain that is protonated, therefore having a positive charge here. This positive charge is positioned in the channel of the protein that extend across the membrane and through which protons are pumped from cytosolic to extracellular side. The channel is narrow on the cytosolic side and lined with hydrophobic residues, with the exception of aspartic acid at 96, which has been shown to function critical role in protein pump. In contrast, the channel is wide and hydrophilic on the extra cellular side and includes a second essential aspartic 85. Another important aspect of this protein is that this protein adapts two different conformational states, T10 form and R form. The T state binds transretinal tightly, while the R state binds cisretinal tightly. This slide explains the mechanism of photocycle occurring in Bacteriorhodopsin. Initial state is going to be T state, which has a transform of retina. Retina is very close to the aspartic 85 in the middle, with the light being illuminated. Retina changes to cis from trans, that just induce transfer of the ship's base proton to the aspartic group. So the resulting structure will be neutral pair instead of a positive negative charge. Such a neutral pair change protein structure from T to R. Such a conformational change involves a reorganization of some of the transmembrane helices that binds retina. As a result, the shift base is moved from the extracellular part of the channel to the cytoplasmic part, away from aspartic exceed 85 towards aspartic exceed 96. Aspartic 85 then delivers a protein through the hydrophilic part of the channel to the extracellular space. Such neighboring allows proton movement from aspartic 96 to the shift base. So protonated shift base changes its conformational structure back to the T state, the starting point, ready for another cycle of photoisomerization induced proton transport.